Smartphones are becoming smarter day by day, whether it is any Android or any iOS. Though iPhone has one of the best things, like it has a premium build design, one of the best user interface, and one of the best camera. But still, when it comes to what to choose, I always recommend Android. And maybe you guys are wondering what I'm doing here. This is Ayushi's channel. So let's just call her.
Here I am. Hi guys, this is Himanshu and this is Ayushi, and we're collaborating for the first time. He's gonna convert me into an Android user. Let's see if that goes well. And I did the same on his channel, trying to convert him into an Apple user. Do check out that video as well. I'm gonna leave it in the description box. And do subscribe to his channel, do subscribe to my channel as well, and keep watching. Himanshu is going to quickly go over points that make the Android phones cool. So we're going to let him take over now.
So the first thing which always comes in my mind is the customization. You can customize Android the way you want. You can install live wallpapers. You can add widgets on your home screen. And you can even install some custom ROMs in your device. And at the same time, Apple likes to keep things simple and user-friendly. I think which is fine. Don't you think?
Yeah, I mean, you should have a simple phone. Why do you want to complicate your life? Not everybody needs a customizable ROM.
People actually need, but I think they don't know how cool it is.
Maybe that's true.
I still believe that hardware part will really make a difference between Android and iPhones. Though people can argue on softwares, but when we talk about hardware, I think we can get a cheaper and a faster hardware in a better price. Let's take two phones. One is the iPhone 10 and the second is the S8 Plus. So iPhone 10 launched in November 2017 and S8 Plus in the April 2017. So you can see a difference between 7 months. Let me tell you that iPhone 10 has one of the best camera, has the latest OS with the latest A11 Bionic chip. But still, if I compare it with S8 Plus, it lacks in some of the things. Like we can expand our storage up to 400 GB in our S8 Plus. We have the latest and the best battery. It has the 3300 mAh battery, and it also comes up with the headphone jack. Don't you think?
Well, cheaper is definitely a point, because iPhone 10, I think, did an overkill with the pricing.
As I already said, that Android offers you expandable storage, which means that you can insert micro SD card up to 2 TB, depending on your device capacity, but which is really a cool thing. But I think that Apple does not provide you, because you have to pay an extra $100 if you want to upgrade your device from 16 GB to 32 GB or 64 GB, which is, I don't think, a cool.
It's not worth it, definitely. You do need iCloud storage, or if you want to buy a phone with more storage, it's going to be at least $100 to $150 more expensive.
That's good. Every device, whether it is Android or iPhone, needs to be recharged once a day. So I want to know it with Ayushi, that how many times you charge your device in a day?
So I have an old iPhone, which is I've been using for 1.5-2 years. That's why I have to charge the phone at least twice to thrice a day.
Okay, so even I have the OnePlus 5 and it is almost 1 year old, and even I have to charge it once a day, but still with the dash charging support, I can charge it in just 1 hour, which is really a great thing for me.
That is true. So that was pretty insightful. Thank you, Himanshu. I think I'm not sure if I want to convert to Android yet. If I do, I might buy the OnePlus 6 or OnePlus 6T. I can't wait for that device. And guys, I hope you liked the video. Do give it a big thumbs up. And also do check out Himanshu's channel. It's called Techportal. He does a lot of Android videos, tips and tricks, and also reviews other gadgets.
If you haven't subscribed to her channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below.
And I'll see you next time. Until then, all I'm asking you to do is pick better.